Over 2,000 people in Baguio City affected by acute gastroenteritis or diarrhea. But the city government says they expect cases to let up soon as food establishments and households adopt preventive measures. The city's health officer confirmed one sample from an establishment tested positive for bacterial contamination. The health department is assisting the local government in controlling and managing cases in the area. The DOH also assured the public water testing is ongoing across the city.
The Philippine Anti-Graft Court denies Philippine lawmaker and former health chief Janet Garin's bid to dismiss the charges against her related to the Dengvaxia vaccine controversy. In a resolution, the court says the allegations against Garin are sufficient and the cases are addressed in a timely and reasonable manner. The case stems from allegations Garin and four other former health officials conspired to realign 3.5 billion pesos worth of state funds for the procurement of Dengvaxia vaccines in 2015. Garin and her co-accused insist on their innocence. Other news, a law firm backing proponents of the charter change drive believes their controversial ad fulfilled its purpose. According to attorney Dante Atienza, the Chacha ad was meant to spur discourse on whether it is time to pursue constitutional revisions and which provisions should be changed. While he admits the ad's messaging could have been improved, he says the ad's proponents remain open to discussing the approach to Chacha.
The ad does not address all the issues na nagustong palitan dahil yung gumawa ng ad at yung mga proponent hindi naman wala, we do not have the monopoly of knowing the problem. Kaya nga man nagkakaroon ng public consultation on the grounds para malaman ano ba talaga ang gusto ninyong palitan. Kung gusto nyo man, napapanahon na ba?
With the line that at least.
But for political analyst Edmund Tayao, the ad is a bad start for the Chacha campaign. Tayao says Filipinos may mistake the ad for a state initiative given its controversial EDSA Puera tagline. Former Senator Laila De Lima also slamming the ad's so-called demonization of the EDSA revolution. She calls the commercial a continued attempt at historical revisionism for the result or for the pursuit of political agenda.
Imbis ng pag-usapan, yung pagbabago ng saligang batas, babalik na naman tayo doon sa supposedly the irony of which is kaya nga natin binabago yung saligang batas para graduate na tayo doon sa away ng mga political families para mas maging substantive yung diskusyon. Dito sa patalastas na ito, imbis na dinadala mo doon sa, you know, higher plane of political discourse, you're again going back to the archaic political discussion.
Meanwhile, President Widodo told Marcos his country is ready to further expand their investments in the Philippines. Before heading back home, Widodo visited Laguna to check on the operations of an Indonesian-owned coffee factory. Manila's envoy to Jakarta says Widodo enjoyed his trip to Manila.
Fruitful, productive, and successful because of the many things that they have discussed. President Widodo and President Marcos discussed a number of issues which are both important for our countries.
Bilateral trade between Indonesia and the Philippines was pegged at $9.5 billion in 2021.
Meanwhile, Germany's foreign minister met with President Marcos in Malacanang. Among the topics they discussed are the South China Sea issue and the president's upcoming visit to Germany. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Victoria Tulan. Victoria?
Ron, German Federal Foreign Minister Annalena Baerbock has thrown in her support for the Philippines in its push for a rules-based order in the West Philippine Sea. Baerbock, who is in the Philippines for the first time, said in a press conference in Makati that tensions in the West Philippine Sea, where the China Coast Guard has used lasers and water cannons against Philippine resupply vessels and where collisions have happened, are a source of concern. She stated that the risky maneuvers of China violate the rights and opportunities for economic development in the region. China's actions also put into question the freedom of navigation, which is key in international trade, economic policy, and security, according to the foreign minister. She said they are committed in expanding training programs for the Philippine Coast Guard and strengthening international law, which is the best protection of all. Baerbock also talked about trade between Germany and the Philippines. She said the deepened cooperation in the renewable energy sector between Germany and the Philippines is of high importance. The 43-year-old German leader hopes the two countries can resume talks on a free trade agreement. Baerbock's Filipino counterpart, Department of Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo, highlighted the valuable partnership with Germany on defense, trade and investment, the economy, and support for the rule of law. Baerbock's visit marks the 70th anniversary of diplomatic ties between the Philippines and Germany. She also met President Bongbong Marcos in Malacanang today. He said he is planning to visit Berlin, the capital of Germany, in March of this year. Ron?
Thanks for that report, Victoria Tulan. Moving on, Indonesian President Joko Widodo concludes his three-day official visit to the Philippines. The Indonesian government has committed to re-examine the case of Filipino death row convict Mary Jane Veloso. Malacanang says Indonesian President Joko Widodo made that assurance during his bilateral meeting with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Manila's envoy to Jakarta says they will continue to advocate for Veloso's clemency. Veloso has been on death row since 2015 after being caught attempting to smuggle heroin into Indonesia.
It's a continuing process, no? It's always in our, you know, in our checklist, and the Philippine Embassy in Jakarta and the Department of Foreign Affairs are working on it. But of course, I cannot predict everything, but I hope, let's hope that there'll be a positive outcome.